Good morning, MSA. This week, during Hispanic Latinx Heritage Month, we are going to be studying an artist named Jesus Rafael Soto. He was one of the most famous op art and kinetic artists in history. He is from Venezuela, which is a Spanish-speaking country in South America. Here you can see where it is in relation to South Carolina, where we live. Jesus was a sculptor. He was also a painter. As I mentioned, he was famous for his op art and kinetic art. Kinetic means movement and energy from your body. So a kinetic artist makes a viewer feel like their art is moving. Op art is short for optical art. This is when artists use lines, shapes, and colors to trick your eyes into thinking two-dimensional objects are actually three-dimensional objects and that they're moving. Take a look at these works of op art and see if your eyes get tricked. Here's some of Jesus's work. As I mentioned before, he was a painter, like the pieces that you're seeing right now. He was also a sculpturist. When a sculpture is put into a museum, it is called an installation. Jesus was very well known for his kinetic sculptures that gave people the sense of movement, even though his work did not move. You get back what you put out, even if you take the good route, can't count the hood out. After a while, you'll know who to blend with, just keep it real with the ones you came in with. Best thing to do is stay low, Locks and J-Lo, they act like they don't, but they know. Yeah. Today for your sketchbook option, you are going to be creating op art of your own. The op art that we're going to be creating has to do with your hand. We are going to make it look like there's an actual hand on your paper. So the first thing that you're going to do is start by tracing your hand carefully and lightly in case you make mistakes. Then you're going to draw horizontal lines using a ruler. You don't have to use a ruler. Notice how she first skipped the hand. Now she's going back and drawing curved lines where the hands are. These lines are going to make it look like the hand is coming off of the paper. Don't forget your thumb. Now she's going through with a darker marker to outline those first lines. Then she's going to take a marker of another color and fill in the rest of the paper. If you don't have markers, this probably isn't the best way to color in your paper. This is one option. I will show you another option if you only have crayons or you only have colored pencils. Notice how this artist isn't leaving a lot of white space. At the end, she's going in to any of the white space she has left over and she's filling it in with that pink marker. You don't have marker or you don't want to color it in the way that artist did, you can use a black marker to outline the first lines and then color in each gap with a different color. For your materials assignment today, we're going to create a string installation in honor of Jesus Rafael Soto's work. Your string installation will last from one day to about 1 week, depending on where it is and how well you look after it. It will make you move around your space in a new way. You will probably crawl, duck, wriggle, and bend. So the first thing you'll want to do is find a room or a corner of your house with lots of things you can tie string to. Next, you want any string that you would like with colors, thickness, or textures. Make sure you have lots of the string to make a cool jungle. Make sure to check with your family first to make sure it won't be in the way. Then it can last as long as you want. Now it's time to create your jungle string den. The first thing that you're going to do is find a doorknob or furniture to connect the beginning of your string to. Then you're going to connect things together, going around everything in all directions. Make sure to have fun with it and be creative. So your options this week are to create optical illusion hand art in your sketchbook or to create a string installation or den in your own home. You will probably need to rewind this video to remember all the steps of both options. Always remember, never forget, have fun! I can't wait to see your artworks, MSA.